Okay, Five Intan, again, a very good morning to all of you. How do you feel today? Apa kabar hari ini? Do you feel great? I hope this is a wonderful Monday for you so far. Okay, so today we will continue with our revision for SPM with Form 4, Chapter 4. So previously, we have finished discussing Chapter 3, Techniques on Measuring Parameters of Body Health. So anyone, if you missed the lesson, you can always refer back to the videos from YouTube. Okay, and this lesson also will be recorded. So whenever needed, you may refer back to the video. No problem. Okay, so let us begin with our discussion. So I hope you can join the discussion actively. I will be appreciate if you can participate in this revision actively. Kamu boleh jawab, boleh respon pada soalan by typing your answer in the in-call message. Okay. So what do we have in Chapter 4? It is Green Technology for Environmental Sustainability. Okay, so what is green technology? I hope you still remember. And how we are using green technology for our environmental sustainability. Okay. So first and foremost, we are going to take a look at a few example of questions in paper one. Today we have 15 questions on paper one. Okay, the first one is very crucial. Soalan ini sangat penting. The definition for green technology. Okay, boys and girls, what do you understand by green technology? Okay, what is the meaning of green technology? Is it A, B, C, or D? What do you say? What do you think? A, modern technology that develops for advancement. B, modern technology that develops for profit. C, modern technology development that emphasizes on nature. And then D, modern technology development that makes living easier. So what is the meaning behind green technology? The terms green itu refer kepada apa? Anyone would like to try for number one? This is testing you on your memorizing. You ingat tak maksud green technology? Okay, anyone? Okay, what do you say? Li Wei, Ben Suan, Ji Suan, Henry, Ji Ying, Dei, Ke Suan, Yu Suan, Hui Shua, Abin Se Si, Ki Sin Ru, what do you say? Jun Kai, Ji Yu, Chu Jing, Sin Ru, Sin Yi, Chi Yun Jia Wen, Jun Jie. Okay, so far, I have one answer here from Ben Suan. He said C. Do you agree with him? Or you have any other answer? Li Wei also say C. Thank you for your response. How about the girls? Or boys? Any other else would like to share your answer? So for this one, the meaning of green technology, yes, very good. It is C. Okay. Modern technology development that emphasizes on nature. So the word green there refers to nature. Okay, we are develop our technology. By emphasizing, kita mementingkan. Emphasize mean mementingkan alam sekitar or nature. Okay, so let's check on the second question. So among the following, which one is not a pillar of sustainability in green technology? If you remember, there are four pillar, ada empat. Okay, tonggak kelestarian dalam teknologi hijau. So which one is not the pillar of sustainability in green technology? So while we are discussing this, you may refer to your module for Form 4 or you may also refer to this workbook. Okay, if you still keep them, I hope you did. So you can turn on page 30. Number one there, you can see the definition for green technology. And in number two, they are the policy and then the pillar. Okay, it's also on page 30. Okay, so which one? Which one do you think is not a pillar for green technology for number two? A, promote energy efficiency. B, reduce criminal cases. C, increase the national economy. And number four, improve the quality of life. So which one is not the pillar? Nothing to do with green technology. Okay, so as I mentioned just now, okay, Junjie say B, okay. Remember, we have four pillars, so means there are three pillars there, and one is not the pillar. Which one is not the pillar? Okay, Ligwe say B, Junjie say B. The rest of you, what do you say? Ini senang saja, you tengoklah mana yang tak ada kaitan dengan green technology, definitely it will be B, boy. Reduce criminal cases. So number one, yes. A, promote energy efficiency. C, also true, increase the national economy. D, also correct, to improve the quality of life. And if you check from this book on page 30, the fourth pillar is to conserve and minimize the negative effect on the environment. So that is the fourth pillar on green technology. So answer is B. Okay, very good. Okay, now let's check on C. Okay, C, what is the alternative fuel that can be used to reduce social scientific issue in the energy sector? Okay, so which one of these four consider as an alternative fuel? Is it petroleum, natural gas, coal, or biomass? Okay, which one? Okay, which one? So far we have how many social scientific issue? Okay, example of social scientific issue is greenhouse effect, global warming, depletion of fossil fuel resources, depletion of ozone layer, water pollution, climate change, air pollution, infection of diseases. You can find this on page 32 in this blue book, the social scientific issue related to green technology. So which one do you think answer for number three? What is the alternative fuel that can be used to reduce socio-scientific issue in the energy sector? Yang mana kita panggil bahan api alternatif? Is it petroleum, natural gas, coal, or biomass? So for number three, answer is which one does not release carbon dioxide? That will be the answer. Okay. In energy sector, kita ada apa? What is the issue we have in energy sector? Air pollution. Okay. Global warming, greenhouse effect. So which one of all these four fuel does not release carbon dioxide or greenhouse gases? Yes, very good, Ligwe. Answer is biomass. Okay, biomass. Petroleum, natural gas, coal, all release carbon dioxide gases which contribute to socio-scientific issue. And the issue is greenhouse effect, global warming, and a pollution. Okay. So now we move to number four. Now you're given a diagram. It shows activity X. Can you name activity X? What's happened here? What do we call this activity, students? Diagram shows activity X performed by human in agriculture and forestry sector. Can you name activity X? What happened to the trees? So what do we call this activity? Ini kita panggil apa ni? Activity X is, actually there are two names you can give to activity X. First one, it can be called as logging. Okay, logging. Tebang pokok, jadikan dia kayu balak. Logging. Another one, it is also called as deforestation. Okay, deforestation. So activity X is logging, or also called as deforestation, penebangan hutan. Okay, so So if they ask you to name activity S, so this is the name you can give it. Logging or deforestation. But the question asks, which of the following is an effect of the above activity? So what is the effect from logging or deforestation, students? Normally, it bring good effect or bad effect. If you read here, all they give you the bad effect. Okay, the adverse effect. A, prevent greenhouse effect, is it? Or B, increase the water catchment area. Or C, causes thinning of ozone layer. Or D, increase carbon dioxide content in the atmosphere. Which one is the effect from logging or deforestation? This is quite easy, simple, nothing to think in a longer period. Okay, apa jawapan dia? What is the effect of logging or deforestation? Was it A, B, C, or D? What do you say? Henry, what do you say? Use one. Huishuang? Junkai, Jiswan, Jiyun, Sinyi, Jiawan, Jiyun, anyone? Number four. Yang mana, which one of the following is the effect from logging or deforestation? Does it prevent greenhouse effect? Is it yes or no? No, it doesn't prevent, it promotes greenhouse effect. Okay, increase the water catchment area if there is no more tree, so no more tree to catch the water. So tak boleh lah ini. For water catchment area, supposed to be we plant trees, not chopping them down. Causes thinning of ozone layer. Remember, ozone layer, thinning of ozone layer causes by CFC. Okay, so there is no CFC involved here. So C is not the answer. So the answer is D. Increase carbon dioxide content in the atmosphere. Since there will be no more tree to absorb the carbon dioxide gases from the atmosphere. So definitely, this will increases the carbon dioxide content in the atmosphere. Okay, good morning, Fang Sun. We are now discussing question number four, paper one on chapter four, green technology or environmental sustainability. So answer for number four is D. Okay, the effect increase carbon dioxide content in the atmosphere. Okay, now let's check on number five. Okay, this time you are given a statement, students. What is the statement? The use of fossil fuel as fuel in vehicle contribute to air pollution. Can you give me three examples of fossil fuel, students? What is an example of fossil fuel? Fossil fuel ini kita dapat dari mana? Deep from the seabed. Okay. We dig down from the ground, the earth, the center of the earth. Fossil fuel, for example, petroleum, diesel, okay, natural gas. So among the following, they ask you which is not an effect of social scientific issue related to the transportation sector. Okay, which one is not the issue related to transportation sector? Mana yang tak ada kaitan dengan sektor pengangkutan? Okay. From this statement, the use of fossil fuel as fuel in vehicles contribute to air pollution. So vehicle ini is transportation sector. So which one is not the issue related to transportation sector? Is it A, thinning of ozone layer, or B, acid rain, C, greenhouse effect, and D, global warming? So which one not related to transportation sector? Not related to fossil fuel. Okay, anyone? Bang Sun, would you like to try? Jin. Which one do you say? On Sinru, Junkai? A very silent. Chujin. On Jiu. Number five, what do you say, students? Which of the following not the effect of social scientific issue related to transportation sector? So, mana tak ada kaitan dengan pengangkutan. So, what kind of gases emitted by vehicle, student? What kind of gases emitted by vehicle? Can you list down the gases emitted from the exhaust of a car? Or the exhaust of a motorcycle? Or the exhaust of a lorry? Yang paling banyak sekali apa? CO2. Carbon dioxide. Okay. And then ada carbon monoxide. Ini toxic gases. Carbon monoxide. Apa lagi? Okay. Any more? And then we have sulfur dioxide. Ini acidic gases. Okay. Ini acidic gases. Ini greenhouse gases. Okay, greenhouse gases. Ini pun greenhouse gases and it is also a toxic. Okay, toxic gases. Okay, and all these are called greenhouse gases. So which one is not the effect? So acid rain, yes, because this is acidic acid. So when it dilute to the rain, water rain, so it can cause acid rain. And also causes greenhouse effect. So carbon dioxide, also known as greenhouse effect, definitely it will cause greenhouse. Okay. Global warming, yes. Carbon dioxide, as you all know, carbon dioxide will trap heat. So it will increase the earth temperature and causes global warming. Okay, ini greenhouse gas juga. So the answer is A, thinning of ozone layer is related to CFC. Okay, vehicle, they does not emit CFC. Kenderaan dia tak keluarkan CFC. So, it has nothing to do with the thinning of ozone layer. Okay, I hope you're clear with that. Okay, now let's move to number six. Okay, students, again, they give you a statement. It shows some example of steps that can be taken to overcome social scientific problem in one of the sector in green technology. Okay, so this is the statement, biological control. Second, usage of compost fertilizer. What is biological control? Anyone? What is meant by biological control? Remember? Okay, this is testing you on your understanding. Okay, biological control is a method where we control the pest by using a natural enemy. Okay, kita kawal haiwan perosak menggunakan musuh dia. For example, in a palm oil plantation. Dalam ladang kelapa sawit, ada banyak tikus. Okay, a lot of rat in a palm oil plantation. So we do biological control by rearing an owl. Kita bela burung hantu dekat ladang kelapa sawit. That is biological control. Okay. Ataupun dekat sawah padi in a paddy field. A lot of, ada banyak apa dekat sawah padi? Siput, siput kondang. So we rear fish. Mereka bela ikan dekat sawah padi tu to eat all the pests, which can destroy the paddy field. So this is biological control by using predator. Kita panggil pemangsa. Okay, by using predator to control the pest or the prey. Pest itu kita panggil mangsa lah. Okay, rat itu we call it as a prey and the owl is called as the predator. It's a predator-prey relationship. Okay, and then second usage of compost fertilizer. How to produce compost fertilizer? Okay, compost fertilizer produced by anything remaining from your kitchen. All waste from your kitchen. Apa yang you buang daripada dapur? Sisa makanan, kulit buahan, okay, bahagian sayur yang you tak makan. Okay, so we turn it into compost. So what is the sector involved? Biological control and usage of compost fertilizer? It is energy, or is it to do with transportation? Or do you think this is referred to agriculture and forestry? Or is it related to waste and wastewater management? So which sector related to this? So this is very clear. Yes, very good, Ligwe. It is agriculture and forestry. Bagus. Yeah. Okay, now let's proceed with number 7. Solar energy vehicles are used to reduce the consumption of what energy? Ini pun senang juga. Okay, so solar energy ini is an alternative energy. Okay, alternative sources. So to reduce, untuk mengurangkan penggunaan tenaga apa? Okay, we are using solar to replace what? Replace electricity, replace fossil fuel, replace wind, or to replace coal. Which one? Kereta paling banyak guna apa? Which one? Vehicles on the road mostly are using fossil fuels. Fossil fuel. This one answer is boy. So solar energy is an alternative energy used to reduce consumption of fossil fuel energy. Okay. Sebab kita tak mau ada banyak greenhouse gases which can lead to greenhouse effect and global warming. So we can reduce that by changing the fossil fuel into an alternative energy called as solar. All right. Okay, number 8. Another diagram you can see here. It shows the release of waste by factory that manufacture tires. Okay, ini sisa daripada kilang tayar. Okay, the waste from a tires manufacturer. What is the type of waste produced by this factory? Dia kata apa jenis sisa? What is the type of waste produced by this factory? Okay, what type? Type of waste. Is it paper? Is it food leftover? Plastic container or chemical waste? This is also very simple. Number 8. What is the type of waste come up from this tunnel entering the water resources? As you can see in the diagram. Ini apa jenis waste? What type of waste come up from this tunnel from tire manufacturer? Okay, so answer is chemical waste. Yes, very good. Bukan paper, not also food leftover, not plastic container, but chemical waste. Ini senang saja. Okay. Now number 9. Okay, number 9. Okay, they give you 4 choices. Which one is not a clean alternative sources? Okay. Which one is not a clean alternative sources of fuel? Is it gasoline, compressed gas, liquefied natural gas, or compressed hydrogen? Dia kata mana yang bukan not a clean alternative sources of fuel. Not clean mean dia keluarkan carbon dioxide yang tinggi. That is mean by not clean. It reduce high content of carbon dioxide. So which one do you think? Gasoline, compressed gas, liquefied natural gas, or compressed hydrogen? Any idea for number 9? Okay, for number 9, the answer is A, gasoline. A, gasoline ini produce a lot of carbon dioxide compared to the other 3. Compressed gas, liquefied natural gas, compressed hydrogen. Okay, so answer is A. Okay, we move to number 10, students. So what do we have here? The waste and wastewater management sector focus on minimizing the dumping of waste and wastewater into the environment by treating a waste or wastewater into something new, such as. So this is one of the effort done in order to minimize the effect of dumping waste and wastewater to the environment. So we do treatment. Kita rawat air sisa ini ataupun sampah yang kita buang ini, kita treat mereka, we treat them and turn them into something new. So, such as what? Compost fertilizer, kerosene, paper or plastic. So as I mentioned just now, semua barang yang kita buang daripada dapur, our domestic waste, we can turn them into what? So it become a new thing and it can use in agricultural sector, for example. So we can turn them into compost fertilizer, this one. Okay, waste and wastewater can be treated and turn into compost fertilizer. Okay. Okay, now number 11. Okay, number 11, still I hope, okay, you can participate well by sharing your idea. It is okay if you give a wrong answer. And then we are here to correct you, no problem. Okay, students, the diagram shows an activity performed by human to build a new settlement. First and foremost, you must understand new settlement ini kawasan penempatan yang baru. Okay, residential area, kawasan perumahan. Okay, so before building the residential area, sebelum mereka bina taman perumahan, they have to clear the land first. Okay, by chopping down the trees. Okay, in a certain area. So how does this activity contribute to global warming? So this is similar to the previous question. Hampir sama dengan soalan sebelum ini. How does this activity contribute to global warming? So what is the relationship? Chopping down trees and global warming. How cutting down trees can causes, may lead to global warming. So is it A, the rate of oxygen production increases, is that true? Or B, the rate of photosynthesis decreases? Or is it due to extinction of species or destruction of ecosystems? So which one contribute to global warming? Yang mana? So again here, the tips, you must know global warming ini relate to what? Global warming ini relate to excessive carbon dioxide gas in the atmosphere. Adanya gas carbon dioxide yang berlebihan di udara. So it may cause global warming. So which one similar to this? Mana yang maksud dia sama? There is an excessive carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? Or is it D? For number 11. Okay, come on. I'm waiting for your answer. Okay, Liquid say A. The rate of oxygen production increases. Okay, betul ke? Siapa yang keluarkan oksigen? Liquid. The rate of oxygen production increases, maknanya who? Who produce oxygen? Green trees, like? Kalau pokok sudah sikit, banyak ke oksigen yang dikeluarkan? Will it be increases or decreases? A ini betul ke salah? Junji say B. Eliwe, want to change your answer or you want to stick to A? B, rate of photosynthesis decreases. So actually answer is B. Okay, rate of photosynthesis decreases. So when we have less number of tree, so less photosynthesis occur. So less photosynthesis mean oxygen will be decreases while carbon dioxide will be increases. Sebab sudah tak ada pokok nak keluarkan oksigen. So oxygen will be less, decrease. Okay. And then a lot of carbon dioxide, since there is no tree to absorb the carbon dioxide during photosynthesis. So that's why the answer is B. Okay, jawapan dia adalah B. The rate of photosynthesis. So for this one, you have to be careful when reading the answer. Make sure you read completely and try to digest for a while. Cuba fikir end, baru kamu pilih jawapan yang betul. Extinction of species nothing to do with global warming, so do destruction of ecosystem. Okay, number 12, burning forest. Okay, forest burning is a common method used by some farmer because it is the easiest method. Okay, however, this method causes an increase in greenhouse gases and in result increasingly critical global warming. So this this method practiced a lot in Malaysia and Indonesia. Kalau you tengok setiap tahun, jerebu mesti berlaku at least once a year. Okay, haze. That is due to forest burning. Mereka bakar sawah padi sebelum mereka tanam yang baru. Okay, begitu juga dengan ladang-ladang, kebun. They burn before planting a new one. Okay, this is the most cheap method and the most easiest method to carry. That's why they continue doing forest burning, even though they are realized that the bad effect is global and can affect another country nearby. Okay, so the question is, what is example of greenhouse gas that can attribute to the above situation? Ini senang saja. So what gases related to global warming? Oxygen, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, or nitrogen dioxide? Now, I believe all can get the correct answer here for number 12. Yes, very good. Okay, answer is C, carbon dioxide. Okay. And next, let us proceed to number 13. So are you doing good so far, students? Okay, we continue with question 13. Okay. So again, another statement here. They ask you to study. Extensive deforestation, okay, will disrupt the gas cycle on an extensive mean without control, tanpa kawalan, sesuka hati menebang pokok, okay, berleluasa. Will disrupt mean disturb, akan mengganggu, disrupt the gas cycle on earth, definitely. So the above statement refers to, so what can we relate to the statement here? Is it A, increases development activities of the earth population, or it is due to the increases of the earth population, or is it due to forest a habitat for flora and fauna, or forests are the lungs of the earth? Mana yang berkaitan dengan ini? Extensive deforestation will disrupt the gas cycle on earth. So what do you think causes this extensive deforestation? Mana yang ada kaitan dengan extensive deforestation? This one also you have to read carefully and understand the meaning of the questions. Okay. 13. Anyone? Extensive deforestation disrupt the gas cycle on earth. So above statement refers to A, increased development activity of the earth population, or B, increase the earth population, or C, forests are habitat for flora and fauna, or is it D, forests are the lung of the earth? Okay. This is a question on understanding construct. Why do you think extensive deforestation will disrupt the gas cycle on earth? Kenapa penebangan pokok yang berleluasa akan mengganggu kitaran gas di bumi? So this is because the forests are the lung of. Mana jawapan dia? Nombor 13. Answer dia sebenarnya adalah donkey. Cikgu wrong typing dekat sini. Okay. Answer is donkey. Okay. If you read back the statement, okay, why the extensive deforestation will disrupt the gas cycle on earth? This is because forests are the lungs on earth. So hutan itu adalah kita katakan lung. Okay, vital organ. Bahagian yang paling penting untuk bumi. So anything that disrupt forest or disrupt the gas cycle. On kalau hutan sudah terganggu, means the balance of carbon dioxide and oxygen will be no more. Oxygen dengan carbon dioxide sudah tak balance lagi. So this is why we say forests are the lungs of the earth. Cikgu silap typing dekat sana. Answer supposed to be donkey. Okay. Okay, then we go to number 14. So we have another two question for paper 1. Okay, cow dungs. Okay, cow dungs ini tai lembu, najis lembu. Okay, are used in green technology to produce material that are useful to human. Okay, the thing is, the question is, what is meant by the useful material? Cow dung. Okay, cow dung ini kita panggil apa? Non-hazardous waste, biomass fuel, solar energy, or carbon dioxide gas. Okay. Cow dung ini is a type of waste, right? Dia adalah bahan buangan sisa. So what do we call it? Produce material useful to human. So cow dung ini adalah apa? Is it non-hazardous waste? Or is it a biomass fuel, solar energy, carbon dioxide gas? If you notice, kalau you biasa tengok National Geographic or any documentary program in India, but di negara India, they use a lot of cow dungs. Mereka banyak menggunakan tahi lembu, najis lembu. Okay, in their daily activity. Kalau you biasa tengok kan, kalau you tengok Tamil movie or Hindustan movie, mereka ambil cow dung itu dan dia put it in their wall lah. Dia tampal-tampal pada dinding bagi dia kering. And then from there they use it for cook. Dia guna sebagai bahan api untuk memasak. Okay, so this one the answer is biomass fuel. Okay, cow dung can become biomass fuel in order to replace fossil fuel. Okay, di negara India sangat banyak menggunakan najis lembu ini. Especially in cooking, dia guna sebagai bahan api. Okay, sebab mereka tak guna dapur gas. You know, in certain part of India, most of the people are still in a poor category. Masih lagi dalam kategori negara miskin. Okay, so most of the people there, residential there, local people using cow dung as a biomass fuels. Alright. Okay, and I think we have come to the final question for paper 1, question number 15. Okay, so if you see this diagram, this is what we call as carbon footprint. Okay, carbon footprint. Ini adalah jejak carbon, jejak kaki carbon. So it shows a symbol of carbon footprint. So the question is, choose the best answer related to the carbon footprint. Actually, what do you understand from carbon footprint, student? Carbon footprint ini dia menunjukkan apa aktiviti yang menyumbang kepada pengeluaran gas. Gas rumah hijau. Mengeluarkan gas carbon dioxide. It tells us what activity produces greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide. So greenhouse gases can be emitted from fuel. Okay, and be emitted from gas, okay, and then any waste, recycling, transport, offset, electricity. Either we realize or not, bila kita gunakan electricity, dia pun keluarkan carbon footprint juga. Ada carbon dioxide release, even though in a very small portion, okay. So, the question is, how does the carbon footprint changes with time? What do you think? Kata bagaimana? How does carbon footprint changes with time? Is it increases with time, decreases with time, no change with time, or always changes with time? Changes mean ada kalanya dia bertambah, ada kalanya dia berturun. Okay? Sometimes increases, sometimes decreases. Okay? Changes with time mean from day to day. Okay, day by day, month to month, year by year. Okay, semakin bertambah masa. What do you think happened to the carbon footprint? Is it always increases or is it always decreases or no changes at all, or is it always change? So which one do you think is the logic answer untuk ini? Kalau you tengok logic, answer will be A, increases by time. Okay, number of human increases by time. Number of activities increases by time. Setiap hari makin lama yang menggunakan kereta. Okay, penduduk dunia pun bertambah. The population of the world increases day by day. So, more usage of fuel, more usage of gases, recycling, transport, offset and so on. So, we say ini 15, answer dia A. Silap, kenapa cikgu pergi letak D? A. This is another correction. Answer is A. Increases with time. Okay, carbon footprint increases with time. Okay. So I hope you're clear with all the answer for the paper one, objective multiple choices question. So it's all the important question on green technology for environmental sustainability. Okay, student, do you need a rest before we continue with section B? Cikgu bagi you rehat sekejap about 2 minutes. Okay, so we have 2 minutes short break before we continue with one question for section B. Okay, so I think we do one question for section B and then question two we leave it for tomorrow. Okay, boleh kita rehat sekejap 2 minit. So I will proceed back at 12:19. 12:20 kita sambung semula. Bolehlah you nak pergi minum sekejap ke, nak pergi cuci muka ke, nak pergi makan ke, pergi toilet ke. So you have 2 minutes break. Okay. Meanwhile, for those who are not filling up the attendance form yet, you may do so. Boleh isi borang kehadiran ada dekat in-call message. Okay. You can scroll up and fill up the attendance form there. Okay, for those with printer, you can print out this module. I have sent them in your Telegram group. You print 2-in-1. Okay. 2-in-1 and then use 2 pages. So you can save papers. Or if you don't have any printer, no worries. I hope you can jot down the answer in your exercise book. Okay, I think I make a correction on the answer for the previous question first. Question 14, question 13, answer is donkey. And for question 15, answer is A. So this week will be our final week conducting fully PDPR. So by next week, you can come back to school or we can carry out with the pembelajaran bersemuka. Okay, especially we can focus more on preparation for your amali science. You have amali science or no? Oh, you don't have, sorry. It is closed for those in the science classes only, for physics, chemistry and bio. Okay, so I hope you're back in your seat, students. So we may continue now with one example of question in section B. Remember, section B in paper 2 is a structure question where you must answer all questions provided in this section. Okay, section B, they give you here diagram 1.1. Okay, it shows a socio-scientific issue in an oil refinery plant. Okay, social scientific issue, ini means the problem. What is the problem we are facing according to this diagram? Okay, so this is an oil refinery plant. So the first one, state the sources of fuel used in this sector. Okay, what do you think the sources of fuel used here? apa sumber bahan api yang digunakan di stesen penapis minyak, okay, in all refinery plant. Any suggestion? What is the sources of fuel used in oil refinery plant? Kita guna apa? Do we use biomass fuel, fossil fuel, solar energy, wind energy, or what do you think? Okay, the major or the most common sources of fuel used in the factory or oil refinery plant as shown in diagram 1.1. Nah, ini basic understanding, mengingat. Okay. Soalan ini soalan aras rendah, sepatutnya kamu boleh jawab. Okay, the sources of fuel used in this sector. So the sources is fossil fuel. Yes, very good, liquid. Fossil fuel energy. Oh, enough to write fossil fuel. Okay, apa contoh fossil fuel? Coal, okay, petroleum, diesel, natural gas. Itu semua fossil fuel. Okay, then B. State two social scientific issue related to the energy sector. Apa masalah yang kita boleh dapat when we are using fossil fuel in this oil refinery plant? You tengok atas tu dia keluarkan apa? Asapkan, smoke. What contained in that smoke? So, and what will be the effect? So, what is the two scientific issue related to the energy sector above? So, apa masalah yang berlaku dekat sini? As you know, fossil fuel ini it emit carbon dioxide gases. Okay, it emit greenhouse gases. It also emit apa? Acidic gases such as nitrogen dioxide and sulfur dioxide. So, carbon dioxide gases can cause what? And then acidic gases can cause what? So this is how we tackle the question. It is on understanding, memahami. Okay. So first, it can cause greenhouse effect. Okay. The greenhouse gases released from the burning of fossil fuel, for example, carbon dioxide, it can cause greenhouse effect, okay, or global warming. And second, the acidic gases, for example, sulfur dioxide and then nitrogen dioxide, it causes acid rain. So, ini dua yang most common social scientific issue. Greenhouse effect and then acid rain. Ini you can replace with global warming as well. Okay. Okay, and then question C. Okay, question C, they ask you to suggest. Okay, you have to suggest one application of green technology in handling social scientific issues stated in B. So, how to overcome or how to avoid greenhouse effect? How to avoid acid rain? Which means we have to change the fossil fuel with another type of fuel. Okay, so what do you think? The type of fuel we can use to replace this fossil fuel. Okay, cuba kamu bagi cadangan. Okay. So instead of using fossil fuel, what kind of fuel we can use? First, you can say usage of renewable energy sources. Kita boleh tukar dia dengan tenaga yang boleh diperbaharui. Okay, you know that fossil fuel ini is a non-renewable energy. In dia sekali habis, dia habislah. So, instead of using fossil fuel, we can use another type of energy sources which is renewable. Apa contoh renewable energy resources? Solar energy, wind energy, okay, hydroelectric, and apa lagi? Biomass and so on. Okay, you can give any either one of those energy sources. And then second, we can say practice energy efficiency. Amalkan kecekapan tenaga. Okay. Maksud dia, we run the factory in one shot in a higher rate. kita jalankan dalam satu kadar yang tinggi. Bukan kita bakar slow, sikit-sikit, but in one shot. I give you a very simple example. When you want to iron your clothes, bila kamu nak setrika baju kamu, kita setrika dalam jumlah yang banyak satu kali. Okay, you iron for the whole week. Kamu iron siap-siap untuk satu minggu. Instead of iron, doing the iron every day. Bila you iron setiap hari, satu hari you iron satu baju. The following day you iron another. So itu tak cekap. We call that as non-efficient energy practice. So we practice energy efficiency. So by this we can help to handling the social scientific issues stated earlier in the previous question. Okay. And then question D. Okay, this is another example of application of green technology in energy sector. Ini 1.2. So, you nampak di sini ada solar panel. Okay, so when you see there is a solar panel, so the green technology involved ini is called as solar energy. Okay, solar energy. The solar energy ini is called as renewable energy sources, as I mentioned earlier. Dia tanya what type of energy source used in diagram 1.2. When they ask you what type, you don't answer solar energy. Solar energy itu is the example. If they ask you what is the energy sources used. So what is the energy sources used? So it is solar energy. But when they ask you for type, apa jenis? So you can say kita ada dua jenis saja type. Renewable, another one is non-renewable energy. So for solar energy, it is under type of renewable energy sources. Okay, so I hope you can clear either the question asks you on the name of the energy or the type of energy. Kalau type ada dua saja, remember, renewable, non-renewable. They ask you for energy, we have a lot of energy. Solar energy, wind energy, biomass, fuel energy, wind energy, idle energy, wave energy, and so on. Okay. Okay, next question D2. Okay, I think this is our final question for today. You have to explain how the sources of energy stated in D1 is better for our environment compared to the sources of energy in diagram 1.2. Dia kata bagaimana sumber tenaga yang kamu nyatakan dalam D1 adalah lebih baik berbanding sumber tenaga pada rajah. I think this one, soalan ni salah ni, pada rajah 1.1, supposed to be 1.1. Okay, 1.1 tadi use fuel energy, right? And then D1 itu is renewable energy sources. So, why do you think renewable energy sources is better compared to fossil fuel, a non-renewable energy sources? Kenapa solar energy itu lebih baik daripada fossil fuel? Solar energy is a renewable sources. Why it is better compared to fossil fuel, which is a non-renewable energy? So, ini you boleh tuliskan. Okay. First, solar energy, it do not pollute the environment like the fossil fuel did. Okay. Fossil fuel dia keluarkan carbon dioxide, emit carbon dioxide, emit acidic gases, causes greenhouse effect, causes acid rain. But solar energy does not emit all these things. Dia tak keluarkan carbon dioxide, it doesn't release acidic gases. So no greenhouse effect, no acid rain. So do not pollute the environment. And then second, you can say solar energy or non-renewable or renewable energy do not release greenhouse gases, as I mentioned. Dia tak keluarkan, okay, gas rumah hijau. What is greenhouse gases? Carbon dioxide, okay, methane gases, carbon monoxide, and so on. Number three, you can say it supply a clean energy. Okay, renewable sources supply clean energy. Clean energy mean it does not harmful the environment. It does not pollute the environment, does not OLUDA. Okay. So I think that's all for today. For question number two, we leave it for tomorrow. And then also for the next question on section C. So students, I guess that's all for today. We have finished discussing paper one, 15 example of question, and then one example of question, a structure question in section B. So if you are missing any point of this discussion later, you can refer back to this video. I will put the YouTube link. Whenever you are free, you can always refer to it if necessary. Kalau perlu. Okay, so I guess that's all for today. Thank you very much for your contribution. Thank you very much for your presence. I really appreciate you here. Okay, terima kasih join kelas cikgu. So, jumpa lagi esok. Jaga diri. Tomorrow, I'll meet you at 9 a.m. Okay, so you may leave this lesson and be prepared for the next one. Okay, bye-bye everyone. Thank you and have a great day ahead. Okay, terima kasih. Jumpa kamu besok. Bye-bye.